The Young Turks, brought to you by Carbonite Online Backup. There is a group of extremely wealthy Americans who have created an organization known as Patriotic Millionaires. And what they want to do is influence Republicans in Congress to allow our government to raise more revenue by increasing taxes on the wealthy.
Okay.
Okay, these are extremely wealthy millionaires, right? So to prove their point, they told Huffington Post what they have done with the money that they have saved through the Bush-era tax cuts.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
I'm interested.
One person said that he built a bigger boat. However, he did not employ Americans to build that bigger boat. The boat was built in Italy.
Nice. Okay.
Okay. Another person said that he built a dance floor in his home. He admitted that he did not need the dance floor, nor the parking lot that he also created for his mansion.
Nice. Okay.
Okay, but he might have employed a few people to build these things for his house, but that's about it. Another person says, yeah, I've basically kept the money. I haven't done anything with it.
Sure. Okay. That makes total sense. I mean, it's not surprising in any way that they would do this.
Well, it's surprising because right now we know why the tax cuts were extended. It was extended because the wealthy people give the politicians money to make sure that they are extended. So it's good to know that there are 200 plus extremely wealthy Americans that have joined this organization to voice their opinions and say, hey, look, help yourselves to our money. We want to help society. And that's, in my opinion, that's a definition of patriotism.
Yeah. No, I agree. As you say, nearly 200 signed that letter. I don't look at it as quite as cynically as that these guys give their money to the politicians, therefore they won't do the tax cuts. I just think it's a total inability to frame an argument correctly.
Mm-hmm.
That, you know, and we talked about it. You know, you and I were talking. We were both on Cenk's show on Friday. And one of the issues that was discussed was the 2012 election and how Democrats would handle the issue of tax cuts, and would Democrats let progressives down again? Can the White House be trusted?
Mm-hmm.
And one of the issues that the Republican on the show, Josh Trevino, said was that he's not worried about it, because even if Democrats take a stand and do what they said they were going to do, and Cenk very dubious that they will, and decide to go ahead and eliminate the Bush-era tax cuts, this guy was like, and campaign on the wildly popular issue of, no, we don't need to keep giving tax cuts to millionaires, mm-hmm. right? He says that they won't be able to convey that point, that from a political point of view, it will just seem like, no, the Obama administration is raising taxes. That they won't be able to say, no, we're only raising it on this small group of wealthy people,
mm-hmm.
that it will get conveyed as, nope, Obama's raising your taxes. And I thought, yeah, I don't have any confidence that Democrats will be able to accurately say to voters, no, we're only raising it for them, that Republicans will successfully say, look at this, there's a problem, we have this huge deficit, what does Obama want to do? Take more of your money. That's
right.
How he's solving it. And I'm like, yeah, they won't be able, they should be able to, but Democrats, they won't.
And that just seems to be one of the main issues with the Democrats, and I don't know what they need to do to get over that. It's extremely frustrating because regardless of what they do, the Republicans are extremely talented at taking any type of good policy, twisting it, and making it look like they're doing something terrible to the middle class, when
yeah.
that's not the case at all.
Yeah, I don't know either. I've given up trying to exactly figure it out. I know they're smart guys. I don't mean they're all smart guys. I know there are a lot of smart guys involved in this, and they
mm-hmm.
can't seem to figure it out. I like this guy. He's my favorite guy, Frank Paiatucci, the CEO of New Compass Mobility Service. He's like, what'd you do with the money? He's like, yeah, I probably traveled a little more than I otherwise would have.
I love how honest they are.
Yeah.
That's the best part. Like, I built a dance floor that I didn't need. I don't even dance.
Okay.
I don't even have legs. Eventually, you're going to have a computer disaster, your computer is going to crash, and you're going to lose all your files. But with Carbonite Online Backup, you don't have to worry about any of that because it automatically saves your files off-site. You can access all of your backed up files from any computer remotely, or if you want, you can also access your files through an iPhone or BlackBerry with Carbonite's awesome free app. Carbonite costs just $55 a year for unlimited backup for your PC or Mac. Think about it, that's less than $5 a month. Get a free trial at carbonite.com by using the promo code TYT, and you also get 2 months free if you decide to buy.